I want to talk for just a minute or two about phototransduction. Phototransduction is basically the process by which a photon of light, a unit of light, entering your eye and hitting your retina at the back of the eye, the process by which that light energy is converted to a signal that gets sent to your brain. When we're talking about phototransduction, we're talking about what's happening at the retina. So just to remind you, we've got your eye. There's your cornea. You've got your iris with a little opening of the pupil and the lens behind it. And your retina is at the back of the eyeball, lining the back of the eyeball. And remember, the retina is the neurological layer of the eye. It is the layer that actually detects light. So when light's coming in, it passes through the transparent cornea, through the aqueous humor, through the pupil, gets focused in the lens and passes through and lands on the retina. Phototransduction is what happens in the retina to pass that signal along the optic nerve to the brain. Now, there are three cells involved in passing the light signal back to the optic nerve and onto the brain. The first cell that actually detects light is the photoreceptor cell. So these are your rods and your cones. We'll just say rod for simplicity's sake. Remember, rods detect bright light and they respond to all wavelengths of visible light. Cones are the photoreceptor cells that detect color. And they detect color because they only respond to specific wavelengths of light. Rod cells synapse with a second type of cell called a bipolar cell. Bipolar cells are intermediates, so this is a little bit like a relay with that signal from light being passed off from one cell to the next cell. The third cell in this relay is the ganglion cell. And the ganglion cell actually forms the optic nerve. The axon of the ganglion cell forms the optic nerve and relays information to the brain. So we have this three neuron relay. It's a little bit more complicated than this. There are cells that modify the interactions between rod cells, bipolar cells, and ganglion cells. You may encounter the terms horizontal cells and amacrine cells, but we're going to not talk about those for a moment, and we're just going to focus on the relay of signals between rod cells, bipolar cells, and ganglion cells. To understand phototransduction, you have to understand what's happening in these cells in both the dark, so when there isn't light hitting the rod cell, hitting the photoreceptor cell, and what happens in the light, so when a photon, a little energy unit of light, actually hits a rod cell. Now, rod cells and bipolar cells are a little bit unusual for neural cells. They actually depolarize, and they actually fire an action potential under resting conditions. in the resting state, they have sodium leaking across their membrane, and they depolarize to the point where they can actually fire an action potential in the absence of stimulation. So what that means is that in the dark, the rod cell is actually depolarized. And since the rod cell is depolarized in the dark, that means that you have action potentials running down that rod cell axon, and you have neurotransmitter being released into the synaptic cleft between the rod and the bipolar cell. Now, the tricky thing to remember is that the neurotransmitter that's released by the rod cells is actually inhibitory. So the effect that that neurotransmitter has on the bipolar cells is it actually causes the bipolar cell to hyperpolarize. Okay? And since that bipolar cell is now hyperpolarized, there's no action potential, and the bipolar cell is not releasing neurotransmitter to the ganglion cell. So the ganglion cell does not fire an action potential, using AP for action potential. So this is what's happening in the dark. The rod cells are actually depolarized. They're releasing an inhibitory neurotransmitter onto the bipolar cells. So the bipolar cell is inhibited, it's hyperpolarized, and it's not releasing anything onto the ganglion cell, so the ganglion cell is not firing, and there's no signal going to the brain. With me so far? Okay, now let's talk about how this changes when you have light energy coming in and hitting that rhodopsin molecule in the photoreceptor cell. Now, rhodopsin is the molecule in the molecular complex within rod cells that actually responds to light. So when a photon of light hits rhodopsin, that actually causes the sodium channels in rod cells to close. So the rod cell actually repolarizes. Since the rod cell is repolarized, it's no longer firing an action potential. So that action potential is gone. And so it's also no longer releasing any inhibitory neurotransmitters. So those guys are gone. Now remember, the bipolar cells, if they're left alone, completely to their own devices, they will fire an action potential. So if that inhibitory neurotransmitter is gone, I should say once that inhibitory neurotransmitter is gone, the bipolar cell actually fires an action potential. So you have an action potential rushing down the bipolar cell. Bipolar cell releases its neurotransmitter onto the ganglion cell, and this neurotransmitter, the one released by the bipolar cells, is actually excitatory. So it stimulates the ganglion cell. The ganglion cell depolarizes and fires an action potential that sends that signal to the brain. So it's a bit backwards. We're used to thinking of stimulation as meaning that a neuron fires an action potential. But in the case of the photoreceptor cells, the rods and the cones, what happens is that actually they stop firing an action potential when they're stimulated by light. So it's a bit counterintuitive, it's a bit backwards, but it works. And our brain is still getting a signal in the presence of light.